A falsely polarized battery or short circuit are a great danger for your circuit. In order to prevent any damage from happening, a protective element is needed. Today, I'm going to introduce you to a simple yet effective circuit which provides enough protection for your circuits. It only consists of 4 components for single supply or 8 components for dual supply. All right. So let's have a look at all the components we need for our circuit. First of all, there are the 2 transistors, PNP and NPN transistor. PNP is for the positive supply and the NPN for the negative supply. There are the 2 LEDs. Those should indicate if either the positive or the negative supply overcurrent protection is triggered. The 2 resistors for setting the current, so they're the base resistors. They set the base current and therefore are setting the collector current. And then there are 2 resistors for limiting the current through the LEDs so that the LEDs don't get destroyed. All right. So let's get started with the positive supply. First of all, we need the PNP transistor. It should be placed in a way such that the emitter is on the left side, base in the middle, and collector on the right side. Then we need a resistor for limiting the base current. So the base is now connected with this resistor to ground. Then we need the LED. The cathode should be at the collector. And with such a current limiting resistor, we connect the anode of the LED with the emitter of the transistor. All right, that's basically it for the positive supply. The negative supply is pretty similar. We take the NPN transistor. Place it like the PNP transistor. So the emitter is on the most left side, base in the middle, collector on the right. Now we take another current limiting resistor and connect the base again to ground. Now the LED. Now the anode should be placed at the collector. Come on. All right. Anode at the collector, and with the last resistor, the last current limiting resistor, we connect the cathode to the emitter of the transistor. All right. So that is done. Now we connect the battery clips. So the battery clip for the positive supply. The positive supply of the battery, first battery, goes at the emitter of the transistor, and the negative supply to the common ground. For the negative supply, it's different. Now, the ground, the black wire, goes to the emitter, and the red wire to the ground. All right, now we have to connect both grounds with a simple wire. So now we have a common ground. And the last thing we can do is to put the both collectors, so the both potentials, the positive potential with a wire to the positive rail up there, and the negative potential again from the collector to the negative supply, to the negative rail. So here, the blue part is ground, blue part down is ground. The red part connected with this yellow wire is the negative supply, and connected with the green wire, the red part up here is the positive supply. And that's basically it. That's the complete circuit. All right. Last but not least, let's do some tests. For that, I've connected 2 batteries, one for the negative supply and one for the positive supply. along with the ampermeter and the voltmeter. So let's start measuring the potential differences. First of all, between ground and a positive supply. Here we can read around 8.3 volts. This value depends on the battery type you use and on the state of charge. But this value is as I expected. So let's measure the negative potential between ground and the negative potential. So here we can read around minus 8.3 volts again, so that's just fine. Perfect. So let's do some tests now. For that, I've prepared two cases. One, a load where the overcurrent protection should not trigger, and one shortcut, clean shortcut, where the overcurrent protection should trigger. All right, so let's load the positive supply with around 100 ohm. Here we can read around 80 milliamps. The voltage dropped a little to around 8 volts, but the overcurrent protection has not triggered. All right, so just fine. Let's now do the same for the negative potential. All right, so we load the negative potential. Here we can see we load it with around 73 milliamps. The voltage dropped a little more. This depends on the transistor type and the base resistor you use. But again, it's fine. The overcurrent protection did not trigger. So everything as expected. All right. So let's now produce a clean shortcut to see if the overcurrent protection will eventually step in and limit the current. So I've now removed the resistor and replaced it with a cable. So if we now connect it to the negative supply, we see that we draw around 100 milliamps, the voltage dropped severely, and the LED indicating that we have a shortcut has turned on. All right. So far for the negative supply. Let's do now the same for the positive supply. Let's shortcut it. So again, the LED turned on. We draw a little more current. Again, it depends strongly on the transistor type and then the base resistor you use. And the voltage also dropped almost to zero. I'm Lukas. I'm with the Institute of Electronics. I hope you've learned something today, but anyways, thanks for watching.